Hello. Hey, good morning, everybody. It's Mike. Glad to see you this morning here at Open Gate. God's been good to us. God's blessed us. I just thank the Lord that I was able to get up this morning. God's done so many great things in our lives. I thank the people that are watching that are on Facebook. You can watch us on Facebook from all over the world, and then later on you can watch us on YouTube. God bless you. We're going to have a great day today, and I'm going to turn the service over to Ross, and he's going to say thank you.
Good morning, family. How are you guys doing this morning? God is good, isn't he? Come on, somebody say, God is good. Here it says, 1 John chapter 4, chapter 9 and 11. It says, this is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. That's so awesome, isn't it, that we can't love God? We can't do it. We don't have the power. We don't have the strength to love. We don't have the strength to go on without God. So this morning, Lord, fill us. Help us to love. Help us to be your witnesses this morning. Let that be our prayer as we sing these songs.
My everything, I would not trust in you.
brother. Play it.
Oh, man.
And you're strong like a river. And your love is running through all my fountains. They are in you. Where does your joy come from? Got a question. Where does your joy come from?
God.
Doesn't come from when you win on a, you know, trying to get a lottery ticket and you win. what about a really good Christmas bonus? Huh? Your joy. He's like, it wouldn't be bad. It wouldn't be, you know, not too bad. What about, let's see here. What about a big old COVID check? A COVID stimulus check. How does our joy come from that? Where does our joy come from? It comes from the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength, right? You know, the saddest thing, it's the saddest thing. When the world looks at the church, how do they look at you guys and me? Do they look at us like, oh, they're just a bundle of joy, aren't they? Huh? You know, in the movies, what do they say? It's like, I don't, you know, this is the most boringest place. You know, they're all quiet, they're all somber. And they're all, you know, it's like, no, brothers and sisters, we have the oil of joy. The comes from the Holy Spirit. We got gladness in our hearts. In the midst of trial and tribulation and struggle, we have the smile of the Lord on us because he is smiling on us. We're living in grace. We're living under the mercy of God. Isn't that amazing? I'll tell you what, it's amazing because we're all in righteousness. And you know what? If God wasn't merciful, he would just strike us right where we're at with all the nonsense. But hey, thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. He doesn't do that. Amen. So the grace of God, the joy of the Lord, the forgiveness that we have, we know it's sealed. We know it's real because the grave is empty. The cross is empty. And he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And the scripture says he is making intercession for us. He is cheering us on. He's like, oh, come on. Come on, William. You got it, my brother. Come on. Just lean on my spirit, bro. I'm going to get you through. I know it's bad. I know you might have gotten some bad news, somebody here, but don't, just lean on me. My joy comes from the victory that we got on Calvary. Amen? So let's celebrate. We're no longer bound. We are free. We are free. He who the Son sets free is free indeed. Amen? Well, let's sing about that this morning.
Celebration, the righteous of God be heard.
anybody this morning that's excited? Is it just me, or is there anybody here that's thankful that God set you free this morning? I don't know about you, but I know Pastor Anthony's going to kill me because I can get really excited for the Lord. We all can. We got to be careful sometimes. We don't want to get too excited. But I remember, I want to encourage you this morning, because sometimes in order to get your breakthrough, you got to push through. You see what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to kind of just, you don't feel like it. You got to say, oh, man, I don't feel like jumping, but oh, Lord, I feel it. I can't help it. But jumping and shouting, thank you for all you've done this morning. I remember when I had no hope, okay? I remember when I was drugged out of my mind, lost and bound, had no hope. Pastor Anthony was right. He remembers all that God has done in my life. And I'm not going to sit here this morning and let the devil steal my joy. Because it's really easy, right? Jim and Eric. Now, I'm not saying you jump around and start speaking in tongues and all that stuff. I'm just saying it's okay to jump a little bit. It's okay to lift your hand and say, thank you, Jesus. It's okay. So this morning, I want you just to let go and let God fill you up. Don't worry about your neighbor, what they're saying, or what they're, you know, just say, died on the cross to seek and save the lost. Come on, Maria. The stone. Come on, April. Come on, William. Anybody got a testimony this morning? That's why we celebrate. Come on, say, Jesus died on the cross, seek and save the lost. On the third day, the stone was rolled away. He conquered the grave. That's why we celebrate. Sunday, it's a Sunday morning celebration. Righteous of God be heard. Let me hear you. We've come to lift our Savior high. We've come to praise His name. It's a Sunday morning celebration. Let the righteous of God be heard. We've come to lift our Savior high. We've come to praise His name. Now somebody shout Jesus! Oh! Somebody shout Jesus! Father, we'll be careful this morning, Lord. We feel it. We're excited. But Lord, we'll be careful to remember that comes from you and you alone, Lord. It's not an emotion. It's not just because we want to rattle the cage and get all crazy. But Lord, we can't help but thank you. We can't help but praise you. We can't help but shout when we think about what you brought us through. Just like the Egyptians, or when Pharaoh in the Bible, Lord. Do you think they just stood there and just, oh, here's another day? No, they shouted. They got excited because God set them free, just like He set you free this morning. But Lord, we know that only, it's only because of you. Lord, it's only, we seek your face this morning. We don't seek a feeling or a thing, Lord, but we seek you, God. We're so thankful. We're so grateful, Lord. Even though we don't, maybe sometimes we don't feel it. Lord, your love is amazing. You're so awesome, God. Lord, we lift our hands. We just say thank you. Forgive us, Lord, when we failed. Forgive us where we've let you down. We made you look bad. And thank you, Lord, that your love still covers us. Restores and covers me. Tell them. King of Kings, breaking our darkness, breaking into our darkness, so your light, the light of your love, could pierce us, pierce our darkness, and draw us right where you are. Even this morning, Lord, you envelop us, you draw us to you, and here we are, Lord, like sheep being led by the shepherd of love. We see you, we sense you. We have faith in you that you're drawing us to you. So continue to do that throughout this morning, Lord, in your name. And all of God's people said, amen. Let's get out of our seats for a few moments and greet somebody. You can put on a mask if you like. Give them a Holy Ghost fist bump. Tell them you're glad to see them. There you go. join your All right, so who do we have doing our announcements? You gonna do our announcements? Okay. Come on up, we have a few announcements we wanna share with you, and all right, Jeannie's gonna share the announcements with us this morning.
Good morning everybody. Glad to be here. We'll wait for the announcements to come up, because I don't know them by heart. I know Monday is CR Recovery. There we go. Celebrate Recovery every Monday night. 5:30 is the dinner, and 6 o'clock is the study. So, and then 7 o'clock they immerse into their groups. So if you're not busy, feel free to come out on Monday. Then Bible study at the Palms, which they love. 10 o'clock on Tuesdays, they'll be studying the book of Galatians. So if you are not busy, have time to go out there and hang out, celebrate with them, feel free to do so. And they enjoy it. They enjoy it. And then the homeless resource activity on Wednesdays at 2 p.m. Oh, at the Palms. Okay, so this is another activity that they're doing. That's awesome. Two things. Okay, so last week they did toiletry packets, which was good. You guys took them out this Thursday? Okay, so they're putting some more together, and also too with blankets. So you can help there. Then we also have the Kern River Ministry Thursdays at 7:30 in the morning to minister to the lost and homeless. We're going to meet behind the homeroom wall by the Samlin Ballpark. Meet there, and they enjoy it. Be a servant. Do the Beatitudes there. Be a blessing to them. And then youth. Okay, so this Saturday at 5 p.m., at Rusty's Pizza, right here on Olive Drive, we'll be getting together all the youth. So if you have anybody who wants to come who's a youth, we'll be welcome to have them. We're having so much fun. It's a new year. We have new things in store, new visions for everybody, you know, because it's just not one that makes a group. It's all of us with their individual unique talents and skills and gifts that God bestowed upon them to give to his kingdom, which is everybody else. So it's going to be exciting. About it. So thank you and God bless.
Awesome. Thank you, Jeannie. Okay, so where's William at? Where's Will? I wanted to celebrate William because there he is. He celebrated how many months? 9 months. A baby's been born. He was birthed a little chip. Of 9 months being off of what? Cigarettes. Hey, God has set him free from cigarettes. Congratulations, Will. If you come here, come over here for a second here. And let's just pray for him that God would continue to set him free from all the different things. Look at this. He's got his crew of he's got some more right here. I got a question, Will. How, you know, when you were thinking about this, I'm sure there was some months prior that God was leading you to do this. What caused you to even think about it?
Well, I was in my garage. I mean, I've been I was getting ready to paint the garage, and I knew I was smoking too much because. Kind of hard time breathing a little bit, and then that's when I was like, you know what, I need to just quit. I've been saying it and saying it, and I keep repeating myself, but I'm not doing nothing about it. So then I decided I was gonna quit, but I knew I couldn't do it by myself. So right then I asked God to take away any urges or anything that I know that I was gonna have, because I tried to do it before a few times and it didn't work. Everything drove me nuts. I was upset all the time. I couldn't focus. All I could think about was smoking. So I knew I had to ask God for help. And he did. He took all I could be. Even now, I can be around a group of people and everybody smoking, and it doesn't bother me.
Let's pray for William that he will continue to enjoy the freedoms, and he'll get some more feathers in his wings so he could fly higher as God sets him free, right? He's setting us free from many things, so let's pray for William. Lord, thank you for his heart. Thank you for how you put challenges in us, Lord, and you help us to meet the challenges like you did William here. And I pray, Lord, you would continue to open up doors, continue to breathe upon him, Lord. His fountain is filled with your Holy Spirit. We see that, Lord. And I pray you just continue
to help him as he reads your word and as he draws closer to you. Show him the heights. Show him the depths of your love and your freedom. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, Will.
Yeah, I'd just like to thank everybody here for all the support that you've had ever since the first day that we joined. And I appreciate it.
Excellent. Awesome. Beautiful. Beautiful. So that's what's going on in CR. God is helping us walk in freedom. You're watching on the live stream. God can do the same thing for you. He can help you walk in freedom. You know, this is really important because we have kids, right? We have kids, and we really got to be a model. We have to sort of, the message that we live, when we live, we're sending a message. That's one of the core principles of us here at Open Gate Church is we follow the model. Not just what's spoken, not just what's taught, not just what's preached. We mainly see the activity that Jesus displayed. And that's why we do what we do. That's why we go to the homeless. That's why we go to the river. We go down to the lowest part of our city. Below, you know, we go to the dirt. Because Jesus modeled coming to our dirt, the dirt of our life. And it's hard. It's hard. Jesus couldn't do it without him sacrificing his glory and his majesty. So he laid that aside, his robe, his majesty, and he became a baby. He became a human being and was ridiculed by people because he wasn't from the right places. He was ridiculed and people smirked at him because he didn't have the credentials. He didn't have the pedigree. You know, he sacrificed all of that. That's the model. And so because that is the key in how he modeled to us, how we should act, that's why we do what we do. And it's hard. Now, here's where it's hard. It's not hard in general. It's just hard for our ego. That's where it's really hard. Because we live in this world and we're constantly bombarded with the idea that you should worry about your pedigree. You should worry where you're from. You should worry about how you look and how you talk. But you know what? God loves you just the way you are. It doesn't matter if when you speak, your grammar doesn't come out right, or if you speak and you have an accent, or if you aren't impressive to other people. That does not matter one bit to him, because he modeled it to us. And so, when we come in contact with people at the river, with all of their hang-ups, all their mess-ups, we can be confident that as we interact with them, God is pleased because we're walking in his footsteps. The model. Isn't that powerful? It's powerful, brothers and sisters. It's powerful for us because we see Jesus modeling his love for us and the grace that he had in the, you know, as I hear people on the radio and interact on YouTube and social media, I see a lot of pastors and teachers and leaders. For some reason, they like to paint Jesus as a judge. That's one of their favorite things. That he is, true, he is going to judge. But thanks be to God, he's not in that place right now. He will. There's going to come a day when he is going to not set aside his glory and his majesty and his power. He is going to be in his fullness, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. But during this time, he is gracious. He's loving. He wants us to walk in freedoms, like just like William is. He is willing. How do we access that? We just ask. We just ask. Ask and you shall receive. We knock. You know, the idea of knocking on the door, it's not like we knock and then, okay, we know it's going to open. That's not the picture. The proper Greek grammar, when that's laid out, it's we knock and we keep on knocking. We ask and we keep on asking. We don't stop. We're active in it. Sometimes people get that little. I've interacted with a lot of people that's like, oh, I believe already. I believe. I prayed already. We don't have to pray anymore. No. You're missing it. We pray and we keep on praying. We ask and we keep on asking. We knock and we keep on knocking. We seek and we keep on seeking. Just like, it's called active. It's an active verb. It means it doesn't stop. So that's what we are to do. And so we keep on asking. You might say, I don't have it yet. Keep on asking. I don't have it yet, so therefore I'm going to doubt. Well, now we're really getting down to the nitty-gritty. So there's doubt. When you have faith, when you're walking in the faith of God and the confidence of God, you're asking, you don't have it, and you're going to keep on asking like God is going to answer you. Because you have faith and trust, not in getting. You have faith and trust in the character of God. See, when you know God, when you know His personality, you know His character by the model that He set, when you know it, you can stand with your head up, proud and confident, not in your own self, but because of how good my God is. He's going to hear my cry. He's going to hear my cry and my prayer for freedom, for liberty, to be set free. And I'm going to smile. It's not there, Anthony, as the enemy will say, I thought your God hears you cry. Shut up, Satan. Shut your mouth. My God is amazing. I'm going to hear His promises. I'm going to hear His word. If I were to listen to you, I wouldn't even be where I'm at right now. My God is on my side. He is so gracious. He's so loving. He's going to lift me up. That's the way it works. Do you know God? Do you know Jesus? Do you know in the person whom you serve? That's why it's so important that we understand our part and that principle here at the church of Open Gate Church is we follow the model. That's what we do. Sometimes people get things a little twisted. Like, yeah, but at my church, when we did this a long time ago, this is the way we did church. I'm like, sorry, sister. I'm sorry, brother. We're following the chief cornerstone of the church, Jesus. He has established His church. You know, sometimes we get this little, you know, there's like, you know, and culturally speaking, you know, you can go to an ethnic church, like you can go to a black church, and there's a way that they do things. You can go to a white church, and there's a way that they do things. You can go to a Hispanic church, and there's a way that they do things. There's a Vietnamese, a Filipino. They all have their little intricacies. And sometimes when we come together to a different church, like, I didn't like that church. Why? Because it wasn't like my church. That's not the way we interact. God has His church, and it's His church, and we are building a model that's after the model that He set for us. We studied it in the book of Acts. Some people say, you know, but that was way back then. Yeah, it's true. There are culturally some differences. They didn't have cell phones back then. They didn't have Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. They didn't have vehicles. You know, they didn't have all those things, but the essence, the model, they were following Jesus. And so we are, in this day and age, following Jesus. So today, we're going to learn some more about the fruit of the Spirit. And then next week, I'm excited. I'm really excited. We're going to go into
Let's go before the Lord in prayer, and let's ask God to help us so we can see the model, so we can see how we should interact, how we should behave, how our transformation should happen in us. Lord, we come to you and we thank you for your mercy and your grace.
My goodness, Lord, where would we be without your goodness, your love, your mercy, your joy? Oh God, we pray, Lord, you understand the fruit of your Spirit. Help us to understand the Spirit so that we could walk and model the fruit of your Holy Spirit. We thank you in your name. Amen. So you can open up your notes or you're on your phone. You can write something down here. On your phone, you should have something I want to share with you about the Holy Spirit. It's something that really helps me understand. Do you know the Holy Spirit is the most unknown part of God? Everybody, yeah, it's the most unknown. People don't know. They know a lot more about Jesus. They know a lot more about God the Father. But the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit, is the one that's least known about. Now, one of the reasons why is because, just like God the Father, he's invisible, right? Jesus, we saw, he wept, he was grieved, he was angry, he was full of joy, he spoke, he ate,